Hello everyone, welcome to day 15th of Mars Lead Code Challenge, and today's question is encode and decode tiny URL. It's a system design question rather than a typical DS Algo question, and the question states that you are given an input string and you need to generate its corresponding encoded string. You need to encode that string and return a shorter encoded string, and whenever you are asked to return for the actual URL from the encoded string, you should be able to do that using your decode method. So you need to define two methods here, two APIs. One is to encode the input string, the input URL, which is actually a very long URL, could be a very long URL, and you need to return its encoded value. And whenever you are asked to decode it, return the actual URL from the encoded string, you should be able to do it. So let's quickly look at the algorithm that I have created for this. And let me just start the slideshow. Here I have taken a couple of examples that I am asked to encode, and here I need to define the two methods, a get encoded URL, and you'll pass it to your encode method and pass the URL that you want to encode. It will return the encoded URL, and the other one says get original URL from the encoded URL, and the method that needs to be called is decode. So these two methods itself gives you a hint that you need to create a map, and where the first part of the map will signify the encoded URL, which would be the key, and the second part would be your original URL. Now the question comes, how are you going to build your key, the encoded URL? There are a couple of ways in which you can do. Let's talk about the simplest one first. You can maintain an integer value which will signify the number of URLs that you have already encoded. And let me just call it the count variable. Count is 0. And I got https.google.com. I want to get the smaller URL for this. What can I do? I'll check the value of count. It's 0. And I'll attach some prefix to it. So count is 0. Attach some prefix to it. Could be https lc hash slashes lc slash the count. So the first one would become https slash slash lc slash 0. So this is your first key, and you will keep in your map this key, and the value would be google.com. When you are asked to return the actual value, you can simply check it in the value in the map. If it is there, https colon slash slash lc slash 0. If it is there, you return its corresponding value, which would be https slash slash google.com and so on, whatever it is. Similarly, now comes the next string, the leetcode.com. I'll increment the count variable post the processing, and count becomes 1. It could be equal to size of the map as well. And now comes lead code. I'll create a new key, and that key would be equal to https slash slash lc slash 1, and the value would be leetcode.com. Pretty simple way of doing it. The other way is to use the hash code API of any string. From string you can generate its hash code, and you can keep it in the key instead of the count variable. That is also quite simple and a similar way of processing. So the problem reduces to key building logic rather than decoding and encoding. The actual problem is to build the appropriate keys and keep it in the map. I'll explain both the ways in my coding part. So moving on to the coding part, let me just create a map for string comma string equals to new hash map. And I want to encode this URL. How will I do that? I will create the key. Key would be equal to https://lc/map.size. Not even an extra integer count is required. And I'll dump this into the map, map.put key comma long URL. And once I have to return the actual URL, I'll simply check it in the map, map.get short URL. Pretty simple. Let me just try this up. Return statement missing. Sorry, return key. Looks good. And let me just submit it. Perfect. Let's try one more approach. And this time I am using the hash of that URL as a key. So long URL dot hash code. So this will return the hash code, and I'll use the hash code as my key in the map. Let me just try this up. No, I have kept it as integer. So let me just convert it into a string. Looks good. And let's just submit it. Accepted. So this is the second way of solving it. The only thing that has changed is the key generation logic. Also, what you can do in this approach, you don't even need https/lc. You can simply use map.size. This will also work. Let me just show this to you as well. Accepted. What would the time complexity of this approach? You are getting the decoded string in order of one. You are getting the encoded string in order of one constant time. The only complexity is space complexity, which is equal to order of n, where n stands for number of URLs that you have encoded. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel.